this right here. NBC2 investigator Evan Dean explains how it's all connected.
We all know that the moon orbits the Earth, and that causes our tides. What you may not know is that the moon, it actually wobbles as it orbits the Earth. It's a cycle that takes 18 and a half years to complete. It is that wobble, combined with rising sea levels, that has experts worried.
On days like these, it's hard to beat Fort Myers Beach.
Four for lunch.
But those who work here, like hostess Kathy Doherty, know it isn't always like this. When it storms, the water doesn't always stay where it's supposed to.
It comes right down the alleyway and comes right into Times Square.
Oh my God, that's what I said. It's crazy.
So now you have this sort of perfect storm in a bad sense, right?
FGCU's Derek Buzashi says we could see scenes like this more often and much worse by the middle of the next decade. Part of the reason why? The moon's natural wobble.
The moon's orbit wobbles because of a pull by the sun. And every 18 years or so, it goes through a full cycle, a full wobble. And sometimes that means that the moon and the sun and the Earth are lined up better than other times. And when they're lined up better, that means bigger tides.
That's nothing new. The concern is what happens when that cycle amplifies tides next, in the mid-2030s, combined with climate change, which is causing rising sea levels and more intense storms.
Think to the worst time that you've seen in terms of water rise. So we had a hurricane come through, you saw how high the water got, add a couple of feet to that and then make it happen more often.
Our area doesn't have as high of tides as some other coastal spots, and Buzashi says people shouldn't panic. The key instead is to prepare.
It's not going to, automatically wash away everyone's home that's near the beach or anything like that, but it certainly will have a significant impact. And if you want to address that, you probably should start now and not wait until 2035.
Never really thought about it so much, but definitely Mother Nature is on a tear, I'll say.
For the NBC2 investigators, I'm Evan Dean.